A man saw a family of four on a scooter and thought, "Ah, oh, how unsafe that would be." He came back to his boardroom and pondered over what could be done about it. Well, came up with a plan to have a car which would be small, gave a statement in the newspapers that this car would be about a lakh. The newspapers published it as a luck W. Well, this car was supposed to have plastic doors stuck together by adhesives had it not been for the vision of this man. Well, the car that had a difficult birth and an equally difficult upbringing, presenting the Tata Nano 2012. Well, this car caters very well to the concept of urban mobility. It defines how cars of today should look, where congestion is a mainstream issue and drivers have become mere passengers of the bumper-to-bumper traffic. Well, it's got aggressively small length, about 3.1 meters. This is a record-breaking footprint. And also, there's barely any overhang. Well, the nose looks like it's kicked from the front. Well, this air intake is to allow the air to go inside the aggressively displaced 624cc engine. Now, apart from being aggressively displaced, it is also very unconventionally placed. This rare engine layout actually frees up space for passengers and luggage, exactly for what it should be. And Tata Motors claims this gives it a space advantage of about 20% over the Maruti's 800. In the Indian Ferrari, some aggregates have been placed here in front to actually balance the weight of the engine back in the engine bay. Well, the spare wheel is placed here, and taking this out can be a project in its own. Done. Well, there's another example of Indian engineering that I must give you. The lead acid batteries have been placed down here to balance the center of gravity of the tall boy design. Also, the roof here is ripped to make for structural rigidity. Ash is a single piece of plastic, but storage space is built in here. The symmetry about the central console would make it very easy for Tata Motors to make this from a right-hand drive to a left-hand drive. Well, in order to cut down costs, there's only one stalk on the steering wheel for indicators, wipers and headlamps. And also, the headrest here is meshed into the lumbar support, again to cut down costs. But I'm still happy with what has turned out, considering there are folks at Tata Motors who's actually strolling through the brochures of furniture to figure out the right seat for the car. Tata Nano was supposed to be to India what Model T was to US, and let me tell you, it is getting there, because Tata Motors is now talking the right language. It is talking to the younger India, one that is fresh on job or is enjoying the college life and definitely prefers the concept of personal mobility over standing in queues waiting for buses only to be pushed by a desperate crowd. Well, an India for which the Nano could actually be their Khushiyon Ki Chabi. The Nano is a great city car. You can imagine doing your daily runs to the shop or kids' school with great ease. Like I said, its small footprint is a bane for urban roads, where gridlock is an everyday affair. It is bang on for those who have to carry along their family on scooter and bike, which can be too risky a proposition. Well, the steering is not powered, and I'm just trying to think, when was the last time when I drove a car with a purely mechanical steering wheel? Well, probably not even when I was 18. Despite that, this car is not letting me miss a powered steering.
That said, full 360 degree rotating the steering of a stationary car can be quite a pain. But for the cost it comes at, do you really care?
Well, the noise, vibration, harshness levels are still refined, considering that this is a car where passengers share the cabin with the engine.
Come back home and it can fit into the tightest of parking spots. Small is a revolution and Nanolution is inevitable.